Now, I'm going to get into this. I took small pieces of maple and I glued it in strategically in this mold. And so what I'm planning on doing with this is I'm going to pour resin in it, of course. And I'm thinking purple, and we'll see what goes on from there. All right. I'm also testing out a new resin that I bought. I want to see how well it turns out. Never used this one before, but it's had a lot of great reviews. So let's test this out. All right. You have the resin and you have hardener right here. And no, they didn't pay me to review this. I did it on my own. I just wanted to see how well it turns out, because just because, I guess. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take my normal and I'm going to fill probably about 8 ounces on each one. 8 ounce of resin and 8 ounce hardener, and then combine them and mix them together and make, you know the drill. All right, so without further ado, let's get started. All right, I measured out 8 ounces on each because it's supposed to be 1-to-1 ratio by volume. My first impressions is it's very similar to my last resin that I used, but the hardener is a little bit thinner. And so that might be a good thing because it thins out a little bit more and you get into crevices. Has a little bit longer of an open working time. So that could be a good thing, and but let's just see how that goes. All right, so I'm gonna verify that they are even. Because you don't want there to be any. You wanna make sure that 1-to-1 ratio. I got it mixed and waited for about 20 minutes. Now it's warming up. I'm gonna start mixing the colors. The reason why I chose purple is because purple is my wife's favorite color. And purple, red, and she likes black. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to mix a little bit of white, a little bit of black, and a whole lot of purple. All right, so let's put that in here. Like I said, just a little bit. And then here, all right. Because like I said, it is a new resin, so I don't know how well it doesn't give you the instructions about the temperature or what should be for it. So I can feel it burning up quickly, but I got it out of the pressure pot, and I discovered that a lot of that resin seeped down into pores, which is a good thing, but also it only came up to here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix another batch and create kind of a trim. So it can be a good thing, and I can also use that to make something for the lid. And with that, I'm going to put a piece of wood inside that's going to act as a filler. That is in the pressure pot. I made, apparently, too much. So that is going to be going into too much pot, the too much project. I really don't remember what wood that is. I think it could be a couple of different woods, but as you can see, there's lines, and it's going to be very colorful when it's finished. It's going to be a while before I get there. got a little bit of a blowout right about here, and it's a little bit of cleanup work over here before I start sanding it, and then get this. Then I get started on the lid. Gotta take care of that situation right here. Right. I'm not gonna bore you with that one. you think of that? All right, it's all pretty much done except for the finished sanding. That's going to be a little messy. So I put a cloth over where the motor is. And, all right, let's get this finished. You might be wondering about the whole thing with the powders, is that when I use a lacquer finish, sometimes I use a pumice stone finish for it, finish sanding it to give a nice smooth and a nice shiny. I start with a 2F and a 4F pumice stone, and then I use a rotten stone to finish it off. Yeah. So what do you think of that? Anyway, this has been a lot of fun making. It kind of reminds me of an ice cream sundae, so I'm going to call it Lavender Sundae. Anyway, well, take to the comments and let me know what you think of it. And while you're there, push thumbs up. And if you would, do me a favor and push subscribe. I really do enjoy making these, and I enjoy making, you know, various different things. And so if you push subscribe, you can help the channel out. Thank you. Alrighty. Off to the next one.